General Motors. The company manages a wide range of products, but today we are going to talk about motor covers.
These are all of the operations that we identified in the manufacturing process. So each one of them have a workforce and a workday's established.
Okay, now we are going to talk about strengths and opportunities. The strengths are that they have a high quality product, and also that the company always is able to fulfill the demand because they manage a wide to order model. Also, each process of each product is standardized. And the opportunities is the possible collaboration with the distributors in order to reduce cost, and the diversification of the portfolio in order to export or diversify their portfolio.
Now, to simplify our analysis, we are going to focus specifically in a special piece that the company produces. The piece is called coquilla. This is because this piece has the higher demand and has to pass through almost all the processes in the factory. Also, this is a kind of case and is sailed by parts.
So the capacity analysis is based on the coquilla, which are cogs with which the full tank is assembled. So here we have the scheduled shutdowns that we saw in the company. First of all, in the 50 minutes for a meeting to the guarding boss, also 10 minutes of active pause, and 10 minutes for 5S. And finally, 10 minutes to go to the bathroom, and that is a total of 1.5 hours per day. And the non-scheduled shutdowns is that they stop the machine during 13 hours per day, per month, because of corrective maintenance. And also they work in an 8-hour shift, two per day, and they don't work on Sundays. So the reduced capacity of the this process is 65,000 units per month, and the efficiency is 85%. And here we also can see the part of the effective capacity, that is 55,250 units per month. And also here we have the days they work, that are 26 days per month, and the hours per month are 416 hours per month, and the scheduled shutdowns in total are 39 hours per month. So here we have, we can see the effective time, that are 377 hours, and the effective capacity is 29,029 units. And the real time is 364 hours, and the real capacity of the company is 28,028 units. And the factory will produce 178 units per day.
Now we go to the bottleneck. The company, in order to make the fuel container, has to go through four different processes. The first one is cutting the metal sheets, and that's where the workers cut each metal sheet to put it in the machine, which is the second process, that is shaping the metal sheets through the machine. And now here, the worker put the metal sheet underneath the machine, and then it gives volume. And then we go to the third process, which is welding the parts together and polishing them. Actually, this process is the one that takes the most. And then the fourth one of the final process is that all the parts are sent through a specialized washing to remove the excess oil on surface. And this is because this is a specialized product for the engine of the car. And now, for the bottleneck analysis that we made, is that in a regular shift, they have 8 hours available, which is 480 minutes. But after the scheduled shutdowns, this time is reduced to 435 minutes, which is 26,100 seconds. As I said before, The third process is the one that takes the most. Actually, it takes 90 seconds per unit. So that means that they could only produce 290 units per shift. But in fact, they use more than one person to the process one, third, and fourth. So they could produce around 870 units per shift. Now that we identified the bottleneck would be the second process, which is the one that gives the volume to the metal sheet. And this one takes 48 seconds per unit. So that means that they could only produce 544 units per shift. But even though this happened daily, they do not stop the production of the factory. They keep working on other references.
Now talking about the waste analysis, the company measures the waste. Each coquilla needs to be done in half of a sheet of an iron sheet. Then it has to pass through three processes of cut. They have to cut the corners, give the shape, and cut some circles for the installation of some hoses. The company has an estimated waste of only 3%. This is due that this is because the company sells 285 tons to scrap dealers, and the other is the other part is reused in the process. This is because of the 3%. And this is a photo of the cut of the shape of the coquilla. This is a photo when we went to the factory where we learned about every process in the coquilla.
And finally, we identified the strengths and opportunities of the capacity on waste specifically. First, the company doesn't stop the production because of possible contingency. So they keep working in other references if one machine presents issues. And also, the company reuses the remaining material, and that is the waste, to produce screw, nuts, and other tools. If they doesn't use the remaining material, they sell it. And finally, the opportunity the company should upgrade the shaping machine, that is the machine that we showed. In order to increase the production capacity per hour. So the second one is that the company just worked two shifts that my mentioned before, and the company can take advantage in a tier shift in order to increase the production and increase the sales. Also, they have to improve the relationship with the customer. And the last opportunity is diversification on market and product.